Hi, welcome to my channel. Today I'm reacting to Sri Lankan Long Range Patrol undergo world's toughest training. And this comes from Danger TV. For those of you who have been with me the longest, you may remember me reacting to that New Zealand intake series all about the new recruits going to basic training. Well, that came from Danger TV. If you've not seen it, I will go ahead and link episode 1 at the end of this video. And because of the length of this video, I will be breaking it up into 2 parts. Let's get to it.
Come on!
In a remote forest in Sri Lanka, Special Forces soldiers battle it out to join an even more elite unit. The Long Range Patrol, or LRP. To become a LRP operative, they must undergo one of the world's toughest training courses. With exclusive access to this once secret unit, we reveal their grueling 3-week selection course. That will break all but the best.
For those of you who don't know, Sri Lanka is an island nation just southeast of India. It has about 20 million people living there. And I want to say that is the size of West Virginia.
Sri Lanka's LRP operatives are famous for taking down high-level enemy targets during the country's 2.5-decade-long civil war.
I would be surprised at how long that war went on for, but it's only a little longer than how long the U.S. was involved in Afghanistan and Iraq, so...
managed to utilize some of their very top leaders. Of course, it had a huge impact.
A black op unit that sacrifices manpower for stealth. Long-range patrols gather intelligence and carry out sabotage operation deep behind enemy lines, where discovery could mean death.
I'm sure rescuing downed pilots would also fall on their scope as well.
This elite unit was born from a 25-year civil war.
Tamil Tigers.
The Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam launched a violent campaign against the Sri Lankan government, demanding independence in northern and eastern parts of the country. Post 9/11, the FBI classified the Tigers as one of the most dangerous terrorist groups in the world.
I have seen claims in other videos that have said that during this time period, there was an actual genocide that took place. Now, whether it's official or not, I do not know.
Conventional forces were unable to reach Tamil Tiger strongholds, hidden in remote jungle terrain.
We were going into jungles with large forces, like 25, 30 people. Most of the time, we used to lose surprise.
Smaller teams were needed, skilled in unconventional jungle warfare. In 1996, 20 volunteers formed the first LRP team, a top secret unit trained to infiltrate enemy lines and survive in complete isolation. Until the end of the war in 2009, the existence of this unit was kept under wraps, and the identities of LRP members a secret. Today in peacetime, there are fewer than 200 LRP operatives, a small elite club. To gain access, recruits will have to go through 6 months of advanced training. But just to get there, they first have to survive 3 weeks of hell. Selection phase day 1, Sri Lanka's Special Forces Training School, Maduru Oya National Park. 207 volunteers are undergoing their first PT test, a grueling series of cardio and strength exercises to stress the whole body. These men are already part of the Sri Lankan Special Forces. But qualifying to become a LERP will take a whole new level of mental and physical stamina.
කලින් ප්‍රියාන්විත වැඩ හැටියට ගත්තාම ලර්ප්ලා ගොඩක් ඉදිරියෙන් ඉන්නේ ලංකාවේ. මම ලර්ප් කෙනෙක් වෙන්න මගේ හිතේ ලොකු ආසාවක් තියෙනවා.
At 35, recruit 8 is the oldest in the course.
මට වයස ආබාධයන්නේ මම බලන්නේ කොහොම හරි මගේ ෆිට්නස් ඇති කරගෙන මම පාඩමලා කරා.
A team of instructors watch over their every move. Looking to weed out the weakest. 26-year-old recruit 52 is already struggling. He's failed the first PT test for gripping the rope with his legs.
So it is more efficient and it is better technique to actually use your legs, but that's obviously not what they want to see here.
මේ පාඨමාලය අනිවාර්යයෙන් PTS එකක් පාස් වෙන්න ඕන. ඉතින් කොහොමරි පාස් වෙන්න. කෝස් එක තමයි වැදගත්.
Recruit 52 will be forced to retest in another week. If he fails again, he's out of the course. The men are only at the beginning of the physical part of the selection phase. Next, they must carry 65 kilogram logs for 4 kilometers, with an extra body weight hanging off. It's not just a physical stress on their shoulders and legs. These repetitive drills are designed to test their mental strength.
If anyone's ever done log PT, it's one of the most painful things you can do. It absolutely sucks.
Veteran LERPs know exactly what kind of soldier it takes to join the team. Some of these men's identities must remain hidden.
We are looking for the physically fit, mentally robust, highly motivated, highly dedicated members. These are not ordinary soldiers following the course. There are some extraordinary characters who wants to be the best of the best.
Our training session was very strenuous, so you find that if they don't have endurance, if they are not, they don't have determination, courage, they drop out.
A highly secretive organization, they do not even have their own unit crest.
Becoming an LRP member is a pride, honor in the special forces. Without insignia, without any benefit, without any motto, we don't go for publicity, we don't go for credits.
The next challenge no one is looking forward to. The recruits have 48 hours to march 50 kilometers. To slow them down, their packs are filled with 30 pounds of sand.
I'm assuming he meant that they had full rucksacks on and they added 30 pounds of sand to make it heavier, because 30 pounds by itself is not a lot.
Slow them down even more. They must navigate day and night through some of Sri Lanka's most inhospitable terrain. Of the 201 men left, over 10% will not make it.
අපි කට්ටියට කාල වේලාවක් දීලා නැහැ මේක විශේෂයෙන්ම නිදිය ගන්න. නමුත් අපි යාළුවන් බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන්නේ ඇවිල්ලා මේක අදිෂ්ඨානශීලීව ඉවර ගන්න. එතකොට යාළුවන්ට තියෙන සීමිත වේලාවෙන් තමන්ගේ අරමුණ කරා කොහොම හරි ළඟා වෙලා පාඨමාලා ඉදිරියට යන්න කියන එක තමයි අපිට කියන්න
තියෙන්නේ. The 40 degree temperature will beat these soldiers down. But there's another hidden danger unique to these jungles that the recruits have to watch out for.
මාදුරේ ප්‍රදේශයේ ඇත්තටම මේ අලි ගහනවා ඉන්නවා. හේතුව තමයි දැන් ඇත්තටම අලියත් ඉන්නේ නිවිසන ඉදිරියේ ආ ඉන්නේ. එයා ඉන්නකොට අපේ යන ස්ටුඩන්ට්ස් හරි කවුරු හරි මොකක් හරි සද්දයක් හරි මොකක් හරි දැම්මොත් ඒ සද්දෙට තමයි ඇලර්ට් කරනවා එයා. ඒ ඇලර්ට් වෙන කලබල වෙලීම තමයි වෙන්නේ. අලිය කොමත් අපිට වඩා ෆාස්ට් නේ.
So because of the thickness of the jungle, these elephants can camouflage really well in its environment, which makes it even more dangerous, because the last thing you want to do is surprise an elephant.
තරිය කිට්ටු වෙනවනේ ඒකට ඉතින් අර අපි දීලා තියෙන බ්ලැන්ක්ස් වලින් ෆයර් කරන්න තමයි තියෙන එකම එයාට තියෙන එකම අවස්ථාව. එයාට දුවල බේරෙන්න බෑ කොහොමත් ඒ ලොකු ජංගල් එක.
If surprised, wild elephants can charge and kill a man.
අලින් උද්දෙත්නට අලි අර මාචේ අපි අතෙන් දිතාලි දැක්ක. එහෙම කියලා ඉතින් අපි ආරක්ෂා තියාගෙන හොඳට සයිලන්ස් වල මම පැත්තකට මගේ පාඩුවේ මම ගමන කරගෙන යනවා.
It's only 6 hours into the march, but recruit 8 is beginning to struggle.
ඔව් ගොඩක් බාධක තියෙනවා. ඒට අමතර උෂ්ණත්වෙත් වැඩි. අද දවසේ මගේ ගොඩක් තුවාල තියෙනවා කකුල් වල. ඉන් පස්සේ මගේ තුවාල වලට පොඩ්ඩක් ආයේ ප්ලාස්ටරයක් ගහගෙන පැය දෙක තුනක් මෙතන ඉඳලා ඊට පස්සේ තමයි මම මගේ පොයින්ට් එක කවර් කරන්න මම යන්නේ.
This is not his first time on the course.
මම එකතරයක් මේ වුණාට පස්සේ දැන් ආයසරයක් මම හරි ආසයි මේකට. ඒ හින්දා මම කොහොම හරි බලන්නේ මේකෙන් ජයග්‍රහණය කරන්න. ඒක තමයි මගේ එකම පරමාර්ථය. මම ලව් කෝස් කරන්න ආවා. කරන්න ආවට පස්සේ අම්මා ඊට පස්සේ මම කෝස් එක කර යනකොට අම්මා එක් තැන් වුණා. මාත් අම්ම ළඟ නිතර මේ ඉන්න ඕන අවශ්‍ය නිසා මම කෝස් එකෙන් අයින් වුණා. දැන් අම්මා ජීවිත නතර නැහැ. දැන් දැනට අම්මා දැන් මම ආයෙ ආවා. මගේ දැන් අම්මා තාත්තා මට දෙන්නම නැහැ. ඊට පස්සේ මම දැන් හිත අයියෙන් මා හිත අදිෂ්ඨාන කරගෙන මම දැන් නැවත කෝස් එක කරන්න එකයි.
Recruit 8 has 30 kilometers left to go. Despite his determination, his decision to rest may cost him. Another recruit has just run into some big trouble. 201 recruits are fighting to become part of Sri Lanka's elite long-range patrol. They are nearing the end of a brutal 50-kilometer march. Excessive heat, rugged terrain, and 50-pound packs are slowing the recruits down. But one recruit has just faced an even bigger obstacle.
Elephant.
Instructors have just been given the alert. A recruit has been attacked by an elephant. They need to evacuate him immediately.
අලියා ඔය පැත්තෙන් දැකලා තියෙනවා. අලියා පිටිපස්සෙන් තමයි මෙයා ගිහිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ. අලියා පිටිපස්සෙන් යනකොට සද්දයක් මෙයා කොහොම හරි සද්දයක් වෙන්නේ. අඩිපාර මොකක් සද්දයක් වෙන්නේ. හරි අලියා හැරුණා දැක්කා. ඊට පස්සේ පැක් එකකට තමයි ගහලා තියෙන්නේ.
The medical team is checking for any broken bones or internal injuries.
Why is he not in a sea collar?
Recruit 129 has a small fracture in his arm. He's lucky. Elephant attacks can be deadly. He survived the attack, but not the corpse.
ඇත්තටම මේ සමනින් අලියෙක් ඇත්තටම අස්තියකට වගේ වැදිලා තිබුත් මේව ඇත්තටම කන්ටිනියු කරන්න බැරි වෙන කෝස් එක.
Time is nearly up for the 50 kilometer march. Recruits are rushing to make it to the finish line.
Speed up! Speed up!
Despite Recruit 8's decision to rest during the march and an injured foot, the oldest candidate in the course has just managed to complete it on time.
Kakule amarugati wedi course ek ek me paata ma ek deyak udate en hinda man eka kakul labada amata karagena man මගේ අදිෂ්ඨානයේ හින්දා මම මේ පොයින්ට් එක අවශ්‍ය.
At the training grounds, recruits are gathering for a post-march inspection.
Integrity test. They want to see if anyone actually dumped any of their sand or their gear.
ඔතන වලට පැහැදිලි කරලා කොහේද යන්නේ ඉස්සෙල්ලා. කැම ටික කැම කොල අනිවාර්යෙන් ගේන්න කියලා. තේරුණාද? ඒක තමයි ස්පෙෂල් ෆෝස් සොල්දාදුවෙක්ගේ තියෙන විනය. පැහැදිලිද? ජංගල් ඩිසිප්ලින්.
ඒ කැල ජනරේෂන් කොලේ කැල වැටලා හරි මේ වෙලා කැල පොඩි කැල කඩුවේ පරිසම් නැහැ ඒ හින්දා ඊට පස්සේ තමයි කඩේ මට ලවා දුන්නේ මේ.
But it's not the most serious offense committed today. A recruit has been caught throwing away sand from his pack. It's an immediate dismissal from the corps.
ඊයේ මං තුන්වෙන් ලෙග් එක කවර් කරන්න ගිහිල්ලා වැරදිලා වමට ඇදලා ගොඩක්. ඊපස්සේ හොයාගන්න බැරි වෙ කියලා හිතද්දී මං ආව කැම්පේ. කොහොමද කැම්පේට එන එකේ වැලි අයින් කරනවා කියලා හිතාගෙන වැලි අයින් කරා.
දැන් මේකේ එයා කරනවා කියලා කියන්නේ අනිවාර්යෙන් එයාගේ රියල් සිටුේෂන් එකේ තියා ඒ වගේ දාලා ඇවිල්ලා ඩිසිප්ලින් කඩනවා අනිවාර්යෙන්.
Recruit numbers are dropping quickly.
අත්තව මොඩි ඔඩියන් කසුව
27 other recruits have failed the march.
ඔයසවත් තමුල්ලා දෙන්දා මේ පාඨමාලාවෙන් ගන් ඉන. පෑදීද? පෑදීද?
කිලෝමීටර් 15 උපරිම උත්සාහ කරා. උත්සාහ කරත් මම උත්සාහය ඇතරින් නෑ. නමුත් ඒ මට කරගන්න බැරි වුණා.
The 174 who remain are exhausted and hungry. They think they're about to enjoy their first real meal in 48 hours.
Jungle එකේ ඉඳලා jungle district දිපෙන ඒ වර ඒ වැරදි වලට දඬුවම් දෙන්න ඕනේ. Right. විනාඩි දෙකක් දෙන්නම්. විනාඩි දෙකේ මම අපි යදි කාලෙ වෙලා ඇගෙන ඉන්නවා. Right. Up. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
They may as well skip the apples. It takes too long to even attempt to eat an apple.
Some men smuggled out apples.
So I'm almost surprised they didn't pat them down, but at U.S. Army basic training, the drill sergeants will actually pat you down when you come back from ranges, just to make sure that you don't have any ammo or brass on you. They would call it the Marine fighting stance.
The punishments are used to build teamwork. One mistake from one man means everyone suffers. In a combat situation, that rule is deadly serious. LERPs can penetrate hundreds of kilometers through difficult and hostile terrain. But when missions call for speed, Sri Lanka's special forces have faster ways of getting around.
දාවල ප්‍රතිබලගෙන ඉන්නතර පස්සේ ලංකාවේ ඕනෑම් ප්‍රදේශයක රාජකාරී කරන්න කියන්නේ කඳු හෙල් ඊට පස්සේ මඩ වගුරු ඕනෑම තැනකදී අපිට ෂණිකව මේ දාවන පැදියේ ඉතාමත් සූක්ෂම ආකාරයෙන් හසුරවන්න පුළුවන්.
The Combat Rider Squadron are part of Sri Lanka's Special Forces 1st Regiment, deployed on missions where speed and access are key.
Oh, that is awesome.
පාවිච්චි කරන හැම අවියක්ම ඒ හැම අවියක්ම පුහුණුවීම් ලබන්න ඕනේ. බයිසිකල් එක වෙඩි තබමින් ඉදිරියට යන්න.
From AK-47 assault rifles to rocket propelled grenades.
That might be the coolest thing I've seen Special Forces do.
Back at the selection course, instructors are upping the pace. 174 survivors have to sprint 5.5 kilometers through the reserve's rugged landscape. Their toughest hurdle will be racing up a 315 meter high rock face. They have just 36 minutes to complete the course. In this heat, dehydration can occur quickly and calf muscles start to cramp.
When I was stationed with my first unit in Germany, we would do a lot of vineyard and hill running, and the terrain was horrible. And yes, going up those hills is not fun, but going down sucks just as bad because of all the constant pressure on your knees.
යක් මේක තවසම ගොඩක් අමාරුයි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් විශේෂ බලකායේ ඇති වෙන දුෂ්කරම පාඨමාලාවල එකක් තමයි මේ LRP පාඨමාලාව. ගොඩක් සාමාන්‍ය විනයකට කරන්න අමාරුයි ගොඩක්.
Coming down slopes like this puts an extra strain on their knees. A simple wrong
exactly.
And the course could end right here. Once at the base of the cliff, it's a race to finish. All the recruits have reached the end. But recruit 199 is showing early stages of heat stroke. If he's not treated immediately, it could be life-threatening.
They need some ice sheets.
He has lost fluids, and his body temperature has risen. If they can't control his temperature and get fluids in him fast, he could go into shock and die.
If you have any ice, you need to put it behind their neck, in their armpits, and in their groin. And then you need to get medical attention as soon as possible.
He isn't the only one suffering. Recruit 2 has a lower limb injury that's threatening his performance. Recruit 2 is a veteran special forces soldier who was shot during the war.
My respect to him. I mean, that's an amazing story.
It's the end of week one. 33 men haven't made the grade. And for the 174 that remain, things are about to get even tougher. This course only wants the best. In a battle situation, these men could be faced with some deadly choices. 174 recruits are fighting to become a part of Sri Lanka's elite long-range patrol. These special forces soldiers are pushed to their limits here, because when things go wrong behind enemy lines, a wrong decision can cost everyone their lives. In July 2008, 6 LERP operatives were on a top-secret mission, 55 kilometers deep in Tamil Tiger territory. Their objective, to ambush a high-level enemy target.
In a pahak, yana kota rastavadinge ilakke peminena kiyala wala apata early warning walin danun dunna.
Daakattete ape eklema prahara lakunata passe sampurna gini gannawa.
The team withdraw into the jungle, but they know they need to get back to headquarters fast. Being found this far behind enemy lines would be disastrous.
They would be tortured to death.
මීටර් 10ක් 15ක් අතර වගේ මාර්ගයේ අතරතුරදී දැඩි ප්‍රහාරයකට ලක් වුණා අපි.
Their point man gets hit in the leg. But when the team commander tries to reach him, he too is shot.
The first rule of TC3, or Tactical Combat Casualty Care, is achieving fire superiority before you start trying to rescue your injured battle buddies. And as heartless as it seems, that is the best way to manage your team and your casualties. Unable to carry the injured 55 kilometers back to their own lines, they had to come up with an escape plan fast. The second in command heads back through enemy territory to get help, while his team hides in the jungle.
ඔගුල්ලෝ ගැන කඳුරට කියනවා කියලා ඉවරලා ඔගුල්ලෝ බේරගන්න පුළුවන් උපරිම ශක්තිය යොදවනවා කියලා. දවස් දෙක විතර වෙන වතුර යෝරනා මගේ මම මගේ මුත්‍රා පානය කරා. ඊට පස්සේ මුත්‍රා තමයි අපි ඊගාවට පානය කරන්න පටන් ගත්තේ.
For 4 days they would wait, not knowing if they were going to be rescued.
ඇත්ත මේ වෙලාවේ එකට මෙව එකක් දැනුණා. එයාත්තාවේදී මට මගේ ගෙදර ගැන මතක් වුණා. මගේ බිරිඳ පළවෙනි දරුවෝ සිටියට සූදානම් වෙමින් හිටියේ.
ඒ අවස්ථාවේදී මරණත් අතර සරණක තමයි ඉඳ තියෙන්නේ.
Without food or water and avoiding capture, the second in command survived on what fruits he found along the way.
ඊපස්සේ වතුර තිබුණේ නැහැ. මම එනකොට මට වතුර හම්බුණා. හැබැයි ඒ වතුර වල බොණ්ඩ සුදුසු සත්ත්වක තිබුණේ නැහැ. ඌරණහලා තිබුණා, අලිජරා කරලා තිබුණා, පණුව මදුරු කීටයෝ හිටියා.
After 2 days he reached headquarters. A rescue team was sent in 2 helicopters. This footage was captured by the special forces team. One lands at a secure site to evacuate the 4 wounded men. But they are not safe yet. On the way back, they come under enemy gunfire. The helicopters release flares as a countermeasure. They reach the Air Force base and hospital.
අපේ පුහුණුවේදී හැකියාවන් ඉගෙන තින දේවල් අනුව තමයි මේ හැම දෙයක්ම ලබාගෙන يعني කිසිම ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැතුව ඔයගේ දරගෙනම ගන්න පුළුවන්.
A total of 685 special forces personnel were killed during the civil war. LERP recruit 2 knows the horror of war too well.
සිදිරි පිටම මිය ගිය අය හිටියා. වෙඩි වැදිලා බිම්බෝම්බ වලට අසු වෙනවා දැක්කා. ඒ වෙලාවේ මතක් වෙන ලොකු වේදනාවක් නිතරම මතක් වෙද්දී.
My utmost respect to all those soldiers and to recruit too. I cannot imagine what he's actually been through. One thing about that mission that struck me as kind of odd is why did they not have any comms? They had comms, then they could have radioed in for a helicopter and they would have been rescued on day 1 instead of day 4. I mean, I don't know, maybe it's because they were lacking equipment. If someone has any insight, then please drop that in the comments. If you did enjoy today's video, then please go ahead and smash that like button. And once I film part 2, I'll put it right here. Thanks for watching.